Hi guys, Amores here. You are about to see Windows 95 running on a very modern hardware. Very modern. Well, to be more precise, we have a modern CPU, a Core i3 13th gen Intel, and for a full experience, some older PCI cards with Windows 95 drivers were invited to join the party. And here we have a PCI ATI Radeon 9250 from 2003 and a PCI Yamaha sound card. By the way, this Windows 95 installation started while I was testing an industrial flash module on a 486 configuration with an AMD DX4100 CPU. Did everything work on the first try? Well, on the 486 configuration, yes, everything was fine. The IDE flash module was recognized without any problems and the installation was trouble-free as it should on a 486 PC. After all, this was the most common configuration when Windows 95 was launched. Now let's go back to our 1 GB IDE flash module. Well, with the help of a PCI to IDE and a SATA adapter, it was easy to install it on a modern configuration, especially when there is a classic PCI slot available. Did everything work on the first try? Well, this time, of course, it didn't. First of all, there is too much RAM than Windows 95 was designed to handle. But on this matter, we already know the drill. We have to edit system.ini file and add the max fizz page line. This way, Windows will simply ignore any physical RAM above a certain amount. This time, I went for 256 megabytes, just to play safe. Later, we can use a patch mem by Rudolf Law, and we can let Windows access more RAM. Since patch mem is patching some important system files, we may want to use it anyway. Sometimes it's required to bypass certain error screens. And speaking of errors, on very modern systems, especially on hardware released after 2020, all Windows 9X operating systems will run into this vcache Windows protection error. There is a tiny patch called crackfix from CPU register fix that will deal with this issue. All we have to do is to copy crackfix somewhere and run it via autoexec bat. Crackfix was later converted into a VXD driver, so we can copy it on the Windows system folder and load it as a device using also system.ini file. Either way, the vcache error won't show up anymore, but this is not the last error we have to deal when installing Windows 95 on very modern hardware. Now we have to deal with another Windows protection error, this time caused by a very fast CPU. This error is specific to all Windows 95 editions and Windows 98 first edition. Otherwise, if you watched my videos, a very fast CPU is not causing any troubles in Windows, generally speaking. This error was originally fixed by Microsoft, of course, and later by Windows 98 community, so there is a bootable floppy image we have to load from a floppy or a USB stick, and it will automatically patch some system files, and at the next start we can finally start using Windows 95. Recycling a Windows 95 installation originally used on 486 hardware, then running it on Intel 13th gen hardware wasn't as problematic as you may think. Most of the hardware was discovered automatically at the first boot. However, the PCI bus had to be reinstalled manually. Once the PCI bus was put back to work, I could reinstall the ATI Radeon 9250 GPU. By the way, this card doesn't officially support Windows 95, so it's not the best pick. Some games won't work at all, and there will be some stability issues. Anyway, some games are working great, like Need for Speed Porsche 2000. Now, how about installing Windows 95 on a SATA drive? Some people ask me if an ID drive is specifically required to install Windows 95 on modern hardware. Well, it's not required. We can use a SATA drive as well. The catch is that AACI protocol used by SATA drives can handle natively real mode requests, so our drive will work with Windows 95 in MS-DOS compatibility mode. During the installation, we have to bypass the same errors, but this time we know for sure what's waiting for us, so we can prepare in advance. For example, we may want to create a DOS bootable partition with CrackFix loaded from the start, so we don't run into vcache Windows protection error. Also, during the setup, right after the first restart, if we edit the system.ini file and add the max fizz page line, we don't get any memory related errors. And if we boot from a bootable USB stick loaded with a Fix95 CPU patch, we can avoid most of the errors that are trying to ruin our Windows 95 installation experience. And as you can see on the screen, the whole installation process using a SATA drive wasn't that complicated. Of course, results may vary depending on your motherboard and especially your AACI firmware. And speaking of AACI, let's try to install a Rudolph Law AACI driver in Windows 95. With this driver installed, our SSD drive is not handled by BIOS anymore, but by Windows itself. From a technical standpoint, getting rid of MS-DOS compatibility mode is a very big deal, but in practice, we won't notice much of a difference unless we have to transfer large amounts of data. First, let's see if this driver works. Drivers that are labeled 9X won't necessarily work with Windows 95A. We can try, the procedure is the same. Our SATA controller is just an unknown PCI device as far as Windows 95 cares. Let's identify which unknown device exactly is and let's install the drivers. Now let's open Device Manager and check our unknown PCI cards. This is not resources, no. Maybe next one, resources, memory range. Yes, this is our SATA controller. Driver, change driver, and let's point to our AACI driver. I have to pick four SATA port drivers since there are only four ports on this motherboard. The installation will hang at this point. I guess this is specific to Windows 95, but our driver gets installed and it will show up in Device Manager at the next restart. Also, at the next restart, there will be a blue screen related to AACI complaining about some invalid VXD dynamic link call. It's for the first time when I see this error. Must be related to Windows 95A. However, we can press Y and ignore this error, and next we can get some impressive transfer rates results in a CSoft Sandra 99. This is our memory benchmark. Pretty accurate. In a moment, we can update our drive benchmark. Let's select our C drive. Benchmarking, please wait. We are waiting, and in a moment, we should get the results. And what can I say? These numbers are looking very good, especially at over 300 megabytes per second transfer rate. And what about trim? Yes, there is no trim in Windows 9X, but the way I'm using this drive, I don't have to worry. Not that I'm exactly worried about SSD wear in general. Anyway, most of the data on this SSD gets copied and deleted from Windows 10. If I want to add some new games, this SSD is available in Windows 10 where my archive is accessible. And I'm using this drive from there anyway. Then I reboot and I play games from Windows 95. And speaking of games, I don't know if you noticed, but this time I'm using a PCI Voodoo 3. This way I can play some games like Hexen 2 from 1997 the way it was meant to be played when it was released, I mean in Windows 95 and with 3DFX glide support. I guess it's time to end this Windows episode. I actually started this video to test the matkc.net backport to Windows 95, but when I realized that won't work with the original release, it was too late to ditch all the Windows 98 footage and start over. So I guess this will be a topic for a future video. Thanks for watching. Maybe consider to hit that subscribe button. Thanks.